So I've got a vintage Lator chronograph with a Landeron 248 movement. It's been a while since it's had a service, so I'm going to give it a service. It's also the chronograph function stops after about 55 seconds, so going to have a look at adjusting that so that works correctly as well. There's a couple of bits like the glass and stuff that I've been asked to leave, and like the bezel's quite loose, so I've been asked to leave that as well. So you can see the case back here. I've already loosened up. You can see a couple of marks where people have been in there before, but not very competently. So here you can see the Landeron movement. Give it a couple of winds. Movement is working, but it's not keeping great time, and it does stop. So, but the seems to function okay. We'll gonna strip this down and give it a service. Dials in very good condition, considering the age. I've seen some of these in pretty poor condition. I remember before this had a fair amount of rust, which had come in from the crown, so it's quite lucky that it didn't damage the dial too much. Now it is different, so the dial feet held in by screws. So there's a screw here, and then there's a screw here. So I'm going to just gently undo those. So to let this movement down, there's a very small space here. You can just about see it, see the click there. So what I'm going to do is gently put the screwdriver in. There we go. Let the movement wind down. Now notice on the screw here, there's some extra lines on it. That's there to signify it's got the opposite thread to the normal. So what you'd expect is that you turn it left to undo it, but in fact turn it right and that comes straight off. On this spring, that screw there, it's actually an eccentric screw to make sure that the correct amount of tension is set. So you don't want to move that one. You see there's two screws holding this. You can also see the cams here on top of the true chronograph wheels. That's for central. You center the hands. Always got to be careful with that because it's so easy to bend that pivot that comes at the top. Just I was fine using a pair of levers, makes it come out quite nicely. So now you can see all the chronograph functions have been removed. All I've got left to do is to the going train and the keyless works. You can see here on this bridge that there's a capped jewel with a screw that will be removed and cleaned and then oiled before it's put back on. Remember, when you're taking that one off, you've got to go quite straight up because of this shaft here. Do is take that one out, but this one won't come out just yet. See, there we go. Now you can see the main spring barrel, the ratchet wheel, the centre wheel, second and third wheels. So the movement doesn't look too bad inside. Previously, all of this area here was just caked in rust. Along with the clutch wheel and a fair amount of the keyless works here and the motion works. So you can see the other side of that ca- module, and that'll be for the escape wheel. And then you can see the anchor block setting here for the balance wheel. Again, both of those will be taken out and cleaned up and serviced properly. So now we're going to remove the rest of the motion works and the keyless works. And normally I'd release this spring here before I took those screws out, but because I've taken the now be careful when you take these out, sometimes these little wheels on the bottom stick, so you want to make sure that that comes out nicely and isn't lost. Now for this next bit, we use a little bit of peg wood just to hold the spring in so it doesn't disappear. There we go, that comes out quite nicely. There you can see everything's now been removed, with the exception of these two end stones. So now we're going to get everything ready. We're going to put everything onto the parts cleaner, get everything cleaned up, and hopefully get it running again. So we've now got the movement back from the cleaning machine. You can see it's cleaned up quite nicely. Still got the balance in there, which seems to be doing all right. So first thing, I'm just going to put the going train back together, get the keyless works on, the motion works, get the watch working, and I can put the rest of the chronograph functions back on. These end caps were taken off for cleaning. Just that little screw there. And then we're going to do remove the anchor box spring. So now I've ordered the going train jewels. I can start assembling the going train. First, I'm going to put the mainspring barrel back in. One thing we want to do first, and that's make sure that the click is there you go, it's nicely on the ratchet wheel. Next, I've got to remember that that second wheel pivot does stick out, so thing you want to do. Just take the letter here. Looks like it's working nicely. Now what I'm going to do is just flip the movement over and put the keyless works, some of the motion works, back together. A little bit here. Something here. So now all that works, what we can do. Over. We can work on getting the pallet fork back in and getting the balance wheel back on. So now we've got the going train back together and the keyless works, some of the motion works back on. We're going to get the pallet fork back in. This has had an epilane coat, so should be quite well lubricated and protected. starting to run really nicely now. Amplitude's fairly good. And it still hasn't got a full wind on it. So now we're going to start putting the rest of the chronograph functions back on. Now on this spring, there's a right angle bend. There's a little hole for that there, so that helps locate it. So before you're doing this up, you just want to make sure that the spring stays in the hole and then gently just push that over so that you don't bend it, making sure it stays there. Probably use a bit of pegwood to keep that in place. One thing you may have noticed, that it's all the way over, but that eccentric stopping it from touching that, so now you notice there when it does touch it,
looks like the depthing's out a little bit on that, so we're going to adjust that once it's back together.
I'm going to put these two levers in, so this one goes inside here.
Now remember in this screw, it's got three lines on it, so it's the opposite way to what you think, so you've got to turn it left to tighten it. See, that works lovely there. I'm not going to do this down the whole way just yet, because there's another spring that goes on top. Make sure that it's correct in there. Now I've got this last spring.
So now everything's back together. We just need to do some adjustments on the chronograph components. So we've got a couple of eccentric screws. There's one here, one here, and there's one here as well, that are limiting this watch's chronograph function. So for example, it was getting to, I think it was 55 seconds and then stopping. So I'm just going to adjust these. I've adjusted one here already for this first transition wheel, and then I'm going to do a check what the depth in is like on this centre second here. To do that, I've got to engage the chronograph wheels, so I'm just going to use a bit of pegwood on this lever here. Now you should be able to see, if I hold it up to the camera a bit better, centre second chronograph wheel's now turning, but the depth in on that isn't perfect. So we're going to have a look at that, see if we can get that running better. Adjusted that a small amount. I'm just gonna let that run for a moment and see if that works okay. We're also watching out for the, if I put it back up to the camera, we're also watching out for the change of the minute hand. So, you see the minute hand just there moved. Everything looks to be in good working order. So now we're going to get the dial and hands back on. Make sure it's timed okay, put it back in the case, and we should be good to go. So now I've got the watch back off the timing machine. It seems to be running really nicely now. There's just one thing. So I've left the chronograph running as one of the issues from the owner, the friend of ours, was that the chronograph function stopped, so now it's been running for a fair amount of time and looks to be doing okay. So I'm just going to reset that, make sure they're 100% zeroed, which they are. I'll flip that over. I'll put the hour wheel back on, the dial washer back on. Surprisingly get lost quite a lot. Now we can put the dial back on. There's just one thing. So if I flip the movement over. Just going to make sure that the two dial screws are in the right place. In place, just gonna turn this upside down, make sure these screws are holding the dial in place. Which they are, that all looks nice. So now I've got the dial back on, I'm gonna get the hands back on, starting with the second hand. It doesn't matter too much where this goes. Looks like there's a little bit of dirt on there. Now the next sub-dial hand is for the chronograph. Now you want to make sure that the chronograph is centred before you put this on. Try to centre it before you push the hand down. Sometimes it's easier to use a loop. Perfect. Put a little bit of pressure on. I might use my hand press for this. It just means that you're not twisting at all when you're putting the hand on. It's easier to make it go on straight. Now I've got all the hands on and they're all centred. I'm just going to flip the movement over so that we can take the crown out. There's one thing I'd like to do before I put this into the movement. That's to give it glass there, just to get rid of any dust, if there's any tiny bits left. Doesn't seem to want to come. Make sure the hands are nice and clean. On there. I'm going to do the same thing to the inside of the case. Just give it a bit of bit of a clean out. You can put the case on the top of the movement, flip this over. Sometimes it doesn't always want to go in perfectly. There we go. Sits in there nicely now. You can put the crown back in. Making sure that's all the way in. There we go. Turn that back in. Always make sure the crown functions when you take those out. And now the movement's back in the case, we can get the retaining clamps back in. So it's all in there nicely. Just give it another blast of air. Got a new gasket to go in the watch. So first thing I'm going to do is put that in some silicone grease. It's quite easy, simple. These tubs, just the grease is already inside. Put the gasket in, turn it a few times, and it gives it a nice silicone grease coat. I'm going to put that on the case back. The service has been complete, the case back's on. Chronograph function works nicely and works nicely over 55 seconds, so that's good. And the sub-dial minute hand progresses nicely as well. So that's it. Thanks for watching. If you like the content, and we'll be posting videos up periodically of different watches that I'm working on and clocks. So please subscribe and like the video, and I'll see you next time.